This is LA Powers with 410 TV, and who do we have here?
Kenny J from New Jersey.
Kenny J from New Jersey. How long have you been line dancing?
Since 2002.
Okay, what were you doing before that?
Playing basketball, football, softball, everything, and all the things that I don't do now.
All right. Now, I understand that you've created a few dances?
I have a few under my belt. My Love, Been There, Done That. Don't couple of them, IAKJP Pop and Mr. Lover.
All right, that's quite the collection. Now, do you have a class?
I do. I teach in Jersey, Philly, North Jersey, and South Jersey, and Philadelphia. So,
and what's the name of your group?
I Am Kenny J Productions.
I Am Kenny J Productions. You can't forget that. What are some of the things that you like best about line dancing?
What I truly like about line dancing is the idea of bringing people together, the idea of making people feel important. And, you know, the reality of it is you never know who you're standing next to. This is one of the only places you can have somebody making six figures and you have somebody in poverty, and they don't have a clue that that's going on about each other, and they're actually best friends. And if it wasn't for line dancing, these two people would never, ever speak to each other. So the money, the wealth, all of that, that's irrelevant. What it is, can he do that dance? Can she do that dance? Does he know that? That's where the friendship comes from. It has nothing to do with where you grew up, what side of the tracks you live on, what color you are, how tall you are, how short y'all is. Can he do that dance?
Exactly. Now, where are you from this area?
Actually, I'm originally from Baltimore.
Oh, okay.
I am retired military, so I now live in New Jersey. So that's where I Am Kenny J is from, born and raised in New Jersey.
No problem.
You are such an inspiration. You've been doing this forever. I Am Kenny J's giving out scholarships. How do you do that great work?
Here's the bottom line. It ain't about me. It's about the people that support me. You know, it's about leadership. If you can lead someone without giving that idea that it's all about you, then you can really sit back, give them a mission, a purpose, a cause, and make them believe that it's about them, and they'll get it done for you. So what we try to do is use line dancing, use the dance for the basis of what we want to do, but we want to give back to the community. So we do scholarships. That's the biggest thing we do. We have a Herman and Connie English Scholarship Fund. Unfortunately, we lost these members in a car accident a couple years ago.
Oh.
So, and Herman was our president of our social club.
Mm-hmm.
So we named the scholarship fund after him. He was into giving back to the community and into the kids. There wasn't a day that we wouldn't go somewhere and we'd find ourselves just talking to the kids to see what's going on in their lives.
Yeah.
So we said, you know what? It ain't about putting money in our pockets. It's about give back to this community. And you know, if you line dance, this thing can be so expensive, like this event. Yeah. Try to go to these events every month. So people are putting out money day after day. So the smallest thing we can do is find out a way to give back to the community, to the line dance community. And that's how we do that with our scholarship fund. We do that with our coat and food drives. We do that. We look at health and fitness. We do health and fitness drives. It's all about giving back to the community.
How do you, when you meet these newer instructors, like the first time I met you, I'm like, oh my God, that's Kenny J. I mean, I've been watching his videos since before I thought about line dancing. I mean, How do you react to meeting the new people who are in awe and who've been watching you and who you've inspired?
I let them know that they're the real superstars. They just walk in on the scene and I see them, you know. Like you said, I've been in this for a while, but now you pull up Facebook, and you see some new faces and they're doing positive things. So when they come to you and try to give you the glory, throw it right back at them, because they should be getting the glory too, because they're new and they're coming in and they're making positive impacts. That's what I look for. And truth be told, I follow people like you. I look at people like you, because there's a difference. There's some people that's in it for the money, sometimes it's a business thing, so not to knock that. Some people are in it for the wrong reason. But people that are in it for the love of dance, for the bring people together, I follow people like that. It shows in the way they teach, the way they talk, the way they act. It shows, and I can see those kind of people. And when they come to me and say, oh my God, Kenny J, no, I say, oh my God, it's you. I've been watching you on YouTube. You are the bomb. That's the reality. It ain't always about me. Sometimes you got to look in the mirror and say, it ain't about me. But not everybody can say that.
How do you have such a huge following? I mean, I'm here. I've seen you at a few events. You have tons of people coming in there. How do you have such a huge following? You have lots and lots of classes. I mean, I think you teach at least 5 days a week. Am I wrong?
Actually, I backed off. I used to teach 5 days a week, and some of them, actually 6 days a week, and some days twice a day. But I backed off. I had knee surgery a couple years ago. I haven't really gotten back into it. But the good thing about it, is, and it speaks to your point, I have a lot of folks in my organization. I don't necessarily have to teach 5 days a week because I have folks that do that for me. And again, the key to that is ownership. It's I am Kenny J Productions. I own it, but I got to make sure they feel ownership. They got to feel like this is their organization. It ain't Kenny J's. And here's what I say. I'm Kenny J, but you're I am Kenny J. So that's their organization. I make them, give them a sense of belonging, a sense of ownership, and they'll be willing to go the next step. Kenny, sit back. I got this. So, and that's what it's about, giving them a sense of ownership, making them feel like they're important. Sometimes we get this big head, the ego, boom, 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 boom. And if I don't ever give respect and thanks and praise to the people that support me, then I shouldn't be in this, and I will not survive.
Right, that's true.
I mean, how have you been able to survive through all the ups and downs all these years? I mean, it's a lot of years and a lot of changes. We hear a lot of different things about the ups and downs of line dancing, but one thing that's consistent is I am Kenny J Productions. How's that happen?
That's an interesting point. I think about that. We started our group many, many years ago. And in the Philadelphia area, when we started our group, there were maybe 20 groups. And I look at it now, and I look at it, I say, wow, there's only a handful of groups left. And I look across the country. I have, since 2006, by every 2 weeks, we have this event. And I think I'm one of the only groups that have been doing it that long on a consistent basis, every month, over and over again. And you know why I think we're successful? Number one is because of the people, as I mentioned, the people that are in my group. But number two, I don't get caught up in what they think about me and what they think about me. Because people on the outside are going to say what they want to say. That ain't my business. I ain't got to worry about what they're saying. You know who I care about? The people that are in my group that are representing me. What do they think of me? What do the people that I give these things to, what do they think about me? If they're thinking something bad about me, now I got to be worried. Right. But I think what some of these groups do, they hear the little chitter-chatter on the outside, mm-hmm. and they get caught up in it, and then they want to go and argue. No, okay, such and such says something about you. That ain't my business.
Right.
I know what I'm doing. My business is right here, and I am Kenny J. And that's all I got to be concerned with. And as long as I'm doing right by the people within my group, everything else will fall in place.
Exactly.
Now, if you have never been to a Kenny J class, if you folks at 410 think I have energy, no.
Let me correct you on that. Kenny J used to have energy. He ain't got energy anymore. He be struggling. I don't know if we performed last night. Honestly, if y'all could see me breathing out.
Don't you buy that for a second. I have been at a Kenny J workshop. It is real deal work. This is one. You are such a fantastic workshop instructor and instructor in general. Do you have any tips or tricks for someone like myself who's only been at it? Because you just do such a great job of engaging the audience. You keep everybody engaged. You make it such a high energy class for those who have not taken it. They
Absolutely.
Just are missing it.
And that's key. So, and again, I will allude to this and I will say this over and over again. It ain't about me. Go into that room and look at the audience and you got to say, it's all about them. And I will tell any instructor, especially new instructors, what's more important, see, here's what we do. We get caught up in the dance. You think the most important thing to do is, oh my God, I got to teach this dance right. Oh my God, is it right for this? No, the most important thing is the rapport you establish
yes.
with your students. You establish that rapport. You can go in there this week, tell them go right, and then find out, oh my God, they were supposed to go left. You can come back next week and say, guys, I told you to go right, but it should have been left. If you've established that rapport, they'll say, oh, no problem, we'll go. But if you haven't established that rapport, if you think it's all about you and you present that attitude, when you come back the next week to correct it, they're going to say, oh, he don't know what he's doing.
Exactly.
I'm not going to do it. So establish that rapport. Let those people know that you are there for them. They are not there for you. And that's where we get caught up, and that's where we get mixed up.
Absolutely correct. I noticed that I've been talking to some of the legends like you are, and there's this single thread through all of your conversations that you're giving. You're not receiving, you're giving. And that's about the deepest thing that I've heard since I've been here.
that's, and in all honesty, that's the most important thing of this. It's about giving back to the community. Because now people are looking up to you, and sometimes there's money to be made, and what are you going to do with it? There's a reason you do this. These people come from all walks of lives, and if they can come in and get something out of it, and you might not know what they're getting out of it, so you have to step up to the plate and give something, so therefore you now you know they're getting something because you are taking that step and you're giving.
That is so, I love this. This is such a fun thing. This is such a fun thing. Now, what would you like to tell to the line dance community? Something, you know, that you haven't shared with them before, or something that you just want to share?
You may not know this, but I'm a talker, so I talk quite a bit, and I can go many places, and people will hear Kenny J speak, so there's probably not much that I haven't said, but I would just say to people, and I really want to speak to the leaders.
Right.
It ain't about you. It's about those people you're serving. Find a many people to serve. Serve them, and you shall achieve greatness.
Exactly. Truer words, okay? Truer words. This is great, and that's pretty much everything we have to say, and this is goodbye from 410 TV. Thank you.
Thank you, and thank the 410.
Exactly.